Hello everyone, today we are going to start with the chapter alternating currents. Now alternating currents, basically this particular chapter is an extension, or you can say that to understand this particular chapter you need basic knowledge of electromagnetic induction, which we had already finished with. Now to begin with alternating currents, first we need to have some basic idea about what we actually mean by alternating current and what we mean by direct current. Now whenever a battery is connected to a circuit, the current flows steadily in one direction, and when the current flowing through the circuit is steadily flowing in one particular direction, that current is known as direct current, which we normally call it as DC. The use of the direct current basically is limited to a very few applications. That is, DC current is used in charging of batteries, electroplating, etc. Most of the electrical energy is generated and used in the form of alternating currents due to many reasons, such as alternating voltages can be changed its value very easily from or by the means of the transformer. We have studied about transformer in electromagnetic induction. Also, the AC motors are simpler in construction and they are very cheap as compared to the DC motors. Now when we have seen, or when we have discussed about what are the advantages of alternating currents over direct current, let us now talk about what actually we mean by alternating current. So when the current flowing through the circuit changes its direction, or we can say it reverses its path, then that particular current is called as alternating current. Let us try to get some more detailed information about alternating voltages and alternating current. Now in this particular slide we are going to talk about alternating voltage and alternating current. Now what is alternating voltage? An alternating voltage or EMF is the one whose magnitude changes with time and the direction reverses periodically. If we want to know about the instantaneous value, instantaneous means what? The value of alternating voltage at that particular time interval. So if we want to have the instantaneous value of alternating voltage, then the instantaneous value is given by the equation E is equal to E naught sin omega t. Now in this particular equation, E is called as the value of alternating voltage at given time interval t, which we are referring as instantaneous voltage. E0 is the maximum value of the alternating voltage. It is also called as the maximum amplitude. Okay, and omega here, it is the angular frequency of the supply. Now we all know that omega is equal to 2 pi f, where f is the frequency of the alternating voltage. If we consider capital T as the time period of the alternating voltage, then omega will be equal to 2 pi f, which is nothing but 2 pi upon T. The graph that you can see over here in this slide shows the representation of alternating EMF with respect to the time interval. So here the alternating voltage is plotted on y-axis, and on x-axis we have taken the time interval. Okay, now you can see that the alternating voltage here is represented by a sine wave, and E naught, which is shown here in the graph with the dotted line, this E naught is nothing but the maximum value of alternating voltage, or the amplitude of the alternating voltage. Now you can see that during positive half cycle, E naught reaches to a positive maximum value, and in the another half cycle, E naught reaches to the same value, but it has reversed its path. So we can say that during the positive half cycle and during the negative half cycle, the peak value, or which we called as the amplitude of the instantaneous voltage, it is same, but they are opposite in direction. And that's why when we have to take the value or average value of alternating voltage over one complete cycle, it comes out to be zero. Now let us try to understand what is alternating current. Alternating current is the one whose magnitude changes with time and the direction reverses periodically. As we have given the equation for instantaneous value of alternating voltage, similarly the instantaneous value of current is given by I is equal to I naught sin omega t, where I is nothing but the value of alternating current at time interval t. I naught is the maximum value, which we are saying as the amplitude of the alternating current. Okay, now the value of alternating current or alternating current can also be represented graphically the way we have represented alternating voltage. And if we plot alternating current the way we have plotted alternating voltage, you will also come to understand that the value of I naught over positive half cycle and value of I naught during the negative half cycle, the magnitudes are same, but because the direction is reverse, the average value of alternating current over one complete cycle comes out to be zero. Now you also have to remember that here the equations which represent the alternating voltage and current that we have written, they are E naught sin omega t and I naught sin omega t. Remember that the alternating voltage and alternating current, they can also be represented as cosine function of time. So if we have to write it in the cosine form, we can write the equation for alternating voltage as E is equal to E naught cos omega t, and if we have to write the equation for alternating current, we can write it as I is equal to I naught cos omega t. Okay, both the results, may it be a sine function or cosine function, they are going to give you the same result. Let us go for the next part, how to calculate the average value of alternating current. Now let us first try to understand what do we actually mean by average value of alternating current, or it is also called as mean value of alternating current. Now this mean value or average value of alternating current over one complete cycle, as we discussed, is zero. Now it is because, as we discussed, that the area covered during the positive half cycle is exactly equal to the area of negative half cycle. However, we can find the average value or mean value of the alternating current over any half cycle. And this half cycle average value of the alternating current can be defined as, it is the value of steady current. Steady means it's a DC current which would send the same amount of charge through a circuit for the half time period of AC. That is, when we are saying half the time period should be equal to T by 2, as it is sent by the AC through the same circuit in the same time period. Now this value or half cycle average value of alternating current, we usually denote it with IM or IAV. M and AV, they are the suffix. Now let us try to understand how the average value is calculated. Now we have discussed in the earlier slides that the instantaneous value of alternating current is given by I is equal to I naught sine omega t. Now suppose this I, which is the instantaneous value of the current, suppose that it remains constant for a small time interval dt, then small amount of charge will be sent by the alternating current in small time interval dt, and that small amount of charge will be given by the equation dq is equal to I into dt, where dq is the small amount of the charge. Now if we substitute the value of I here in this equation, we get dq is equal to I naught sine omega t into dt. Okay, now if q is the total charge sent by the positive half cycle of AC, that is here the time interval will be 0 to T by 2, then in that particular case the total amount of charge we can calculate by integrating the equation. So we have q is equal to integration of I dt with the limiting conditions as 0 to T by 2. Let us substitute the value of I over here. So it gets integration 0 to T by 2 I naught sine omega t into dt. This I naught is what? It is the amplitude or maximum value of current. So that will remain constant. So it comes out of the integration sign, and by applying the simple trigonometric formulas or rules to find out the integration, we get minus I naught upon omega into bracket cos of pi minus cos of 0, because here we are integrating the equation with the limiting condition at 0 to T by 2. Now value of cos pi is, that is cos 180 is minus 1 and cos 0 is 1. So it is minus 1 minus 1. When you compare all the signs, you will get the value of q as q is equal to 2 I omega I naught upon omega. Now if you consider that In is the half cycle average or mean value of the positive half cycle of AC, then by the definition we can write that q is equal to Im into T upon 2. Now if you compare equation 1 and 2, you can observe that the left hand side of the equation is same. So we can equate and we can write the same equation 1 and 2, we can write that 2 I naught upon omega is equal to Im into T upon 2. Okay, so if you rearrange the terms and try to solve, you get the equation as Im is equal to 2 upon pi into I naught. 2 upon pi is what? The value of pi is 3.142. So if we solve and work out, we get that Im is equal to 0.637 into I naught. So Im is what? It is the average value of alternating current. So we establish the relation that average value of alternating current is equal to 0.637 into the peak value or the amplitude, maximum value of the current flowing through. Now if this derivation is clear to you, the next part of the derivation, where we are going to find out the average value of alternating EMF, it will be easier for you. Before we go to the derivation of EMF, let me tell you that the value of average value of current during the positive half cycle will be 0.637 into I naught, and when we have to go about the negative half cycle, as we discussed, the magnitude remains same but the current changes or reverses its direction. So for the negative half cycle, the value of Im will be minus 0.637 into I naught. Now let us try to find out the average value of alternating EMF. Now, as we have discussed about the definition of average value of alternating current, let us first discuss about the definition of alternating EMF. So, the half cycle average value of alternating EMF is that value of steady EMF which would send the same amount of charge through a circuit for half the time period of the alternating EMF. Now here also when I am saying half the time period, so time period will be equal to T by 2 as is sent by the alternating EMF through the same circuit in the same time. And this value of mean value of alternating EMF is denoted by EM or EAV as the suffix. Now let us try to understand how we have to derive the equation for finding out the average value of alternating EMF. So here the instantaneous value of EMF, as we have discussed in the earlier slides, it is given by E is equal to E naught sine omega t. Okay, now suppose that this alternating EMF is applied to a circuit whose resistance is capital R. Then by applying Ohm's law, the instantaneous value of the alternating current, we can write it by the equation that I is equal to E upon R. We know that by using Ohm's law, the equation is V is equal to IR. Here V is nothing but the EMF, that is E. So we can write the equation by using Ohm's law as I is equal to E upon R. Now we know what is the value of E, so let us substitute that. This will be E naught sine omega t upon R. Okay, now if this particular current, if you consider that it remains constant for a small time interval dt, then small amount of charge sent by the alternating EMF in a small time interval dt, that will be given by dq is equal to I into dt. Now value of I from the earlier equation, we can write this as E naught sin omega t upon R into dt. Now if q is the total charge which is been sent by the positive half cycle of the alternating EMF, then the total charge sent, we can write it by the equation as q is equal to, do the integration of that, and what will be the limiting condition for the integration over here, 0 to T by 2, because we are talking about the half cycle where time interval is T by 2. So we can write this as integration of E naught sine omega t upon R and from 0 to T by 2. As we did the derivation for alternating current, here also to solve the integration we have to use the basic rules of the trigonometry and solve the integration. So we get q is equal to E naught upon R, which is constant, it will come out of the sign, and integration of sine omega t is minus cos omega t upon omega, and the time interval t by 2 to 0. When you work out this, you get the value of q as 2 E naught upon R into omega or omega R. Now if EM is the mean value of or average value of the EMF during the positive half cycle, then by definition we can write charge, that is q, is equal to EM upon R into T by 2. So again if we equate these two equations, we can write EM upon R into T by 2 is equal to 2 EM into, this is what, this omega, omega is 2 pi by T. So I just have tried to write the value of omega as T upon 2 pi, and this R already it gets cancelled over here. So when you work out with this equation, you get Em is equal to 2 upon pi into E naught. So Em, that is the average value of alternating EMF, is equal to 0.673 into E naught. So from both the derivation for alternating current, average value of alternating current, and average value of alternating EMF, it must have been clear to you that the average value of EMF and average value of alternating current both are related to peak value of EMF and peak value of alternating current with a factor of 0.637. Now, if till this part, that is, what do we actually mean by alternating current, what is the meaning of alternating EMF, how we actually calculate the values for average value of alternating current and average value of alternating EMF, the next part that we need to understand is root mean square value of the alternating current. Let us first try to understand what is the root mean square value of alternating current. Now, we discuss that the average value of alternating current over one complete cycle is zero. Okay, so because the average value is zero, it cannot be used to specify any alternating voltage or current in the circuit, and it cannot be used for calculation of the power dissipated. And therefore, we must search for a more suitable criteria to measure the effectiveness of alternating current or effectiveness of the alternating voltage. Now, the choice to have or measure the alternating EMF or current in terms of direct current would be something which will produce some work, or it will produce heat at the same average rate as the AC under similar conditions. Now, this particular thing, or this equivalent DC current, is called as root mean square or effective value of the alternating current. So this effective value or RMS value of alternating current, we can define it as the steady current which is when flowing through a given resistance for a given time, it produces same amount of heat as produced by the alternating current when flowing through the same resistance for same time interval. This is also called as the virtual value of alternating circuit, and it is generally represented by IRMS or I effectiveness or IV. The notations may change as the author change for the book. Okay, now let us try to understand this RMS value by taking example into consideration. Now, when we say that the RMS or effective value of alternating current is 5 ampere, suppose, it means that the alternating current is going to do some work, or it is going to produce heat at the same rate as the 5 ampere direct current will produce under the similar conditions. Now let us try to understand the derivation for obtaining the value of IRMS. We have seen that the alternating current is represented by the equation I is equal to I naught sin omega t. Now if this alternating current flows through a resistance R, capital R, for a small time interval dt, then the heat produced, this is in accordance with the Joule's law, so heat produced will be given by I square R into dt. Let us substitute the value of I over here. So you get I naught sin omega t whole bracket square into R into dt. Now, in one complete cycle, one complete cycle means what? Starts from 0 and 2 time interval capital T. So, in one complete cycle of the alternating current, the total amount of heat produced in the or across the resistor, it will be given by integrating this particular equation which we have written above. So when we integrate dH, integration of dH will be H. So this will be integration of I naught square R sine omega square T into dT with the limiting conditions at 0 to capital T. Now if you solve this integration using the basic rules of trigonometry as I have tried to work it out over here, you get H is equal to I naught square into R into T divided by 2. Okay, and we also know that if IV is the virtual value of alternating current, then heat produced in the resistor R in the same time interval, that is between 0 to T, that will be given by H is equal to IV square into R into T. Let us equate both these equations. So we get IV square RT is equal to I naught square RT divided by 2. And if we solve the equations, RT from both the sides will get cancelled. And if we take the square root, so we will take, we will have IV is equal to I naught upon root 2. So this gives us the relation between the RMS value and the peak value. So RMS value or effective value or virtual value of alternating current will be equal to 0.707 into I naught. What this 0.707 factor is, if I try to calculate the value of 1 upon root 2, then the answer comes out to be 0.707. So we have the relation that IV is equal to 0.707 into I naught. Okay. You have to remember that the RMS value remains same whether you calculate it for half cycle or whether you calculate it for full cycle. Now the way we have calculated the value for the alternate RMS value of current, same way you can calculate the root mean square value for alternating EMF. We will not try to go in details about that, but let me just tell you that you can derive it the similar way we did the derivation for IRMS. Now just try to understand what's the importance of RMS value. The alternating voltage or current is always specified basically in terms of RMS values. Okay, so as I said that if the alternating current, for example, you take alternating current of 10 ampere is the one which has same heating effect as 10 ampere DC, then that particular value that you obtain is known as the IRMS value. Okay, so let us go further to understand the one more very important concept that we are going to need in alternating circuits or alternating currents, and that concept is concept of phasor diagrams. Now the analysis of an AC circuit becomes very much simple by representing the alternating voltage or alternating current by a line of definite length which is going to rotate in anti-clockwise direction at a constant angular velocity. Okay, and this constant angular velocity we are going to represent with omega. Such rotating line, that line we are going to call, or that is called as phasor. The length of the phasor is taken equal to the maximum value of alternating quantity, and the angular velocity is equal to the angular velocity of the alternating quantity. Okay, so when we have to define phasor or phasor diagram, always remember that a rotating vector that represents a quantity which is varying sinusoidally with respect to time, it is called as a phasor, and the diagram representing that particular thing is known as the phasor diagram. Okay, the phasor of alternating EMF and alternating current, which are inclined to the horizontal axis at an angle omega t or omega t plus phi, the representation, graphical representation, is given over here. The projection of the vector on the fixed axis, if you refer diagram A, then the projection of the vector on fixed axis, it will give you the instantaneous value of alternating current. Okay, in the sine form, if we have to write the instantaneous value, you can refer to the diagram A, and the projection which is shown by the dotted line, it gives I is equal to I naught sine omega t. Okay, and if you can write it in the terms of cosine, then it will be I is equal to I naught cos omega t if you refer the second diagram. Okay, so the first one, it indicates projection along y axis when you are writing the value in terms of sine, and the second diagram, it shows the projection, that is the value of instantaneous alternating current, when you are going to write it in terms of the cosine factor I naught cos omega t on the y axis. Okay, so the representation of the changing or harmonically changing quantities as the rotating vectors, that is representing these quantities, alternating EMF and alternating current, in terms of the phasor diagram, it actually helps us to use the laws of vector addition for adding these quantities, and that is actually the importance or the significance of the phasor diagram.